So let me start my presentation really fast. So right now, like nowadays, one of the buzzwords that we hear the most is plastic waste. We're like everywhere, like almost every day on newspaper, on website, and there's actually no single standalone solution to it. So today, my name is Tran Quoc Trung, I'm the founder of Greeny Bee, and I'll show you how we try to solve this problem. So before we start, I would like to show you two pictures. The first one is the plastic, and the second one is the agri waste. So to many people, they are kind of like the same, because at the end, it will end up in the landfill. It will cause like pollution when we burn it for fuel, and for the agri waste, we do not use it at all. Normally, we just burn it for fuel only. Yeah. So we like Greeny Bee, we think a little bit different. We want to use this kind of waste to create some eco alternative to the plastic waste in here. Yeah. So this is the picture of So like our plant fiber disposable packaging is eco-friendly because it's made from like agricultural like byproducts and leftover. It can be like degraded after like 12 weeks. And secondly, it's pretty high quality because it can stand like heat. It can, you know, like withstand water, and even like we can use it in microwave, oven, and even freezer. And the last but not least, because it's considered like a waste, it's pretty cheap and plentiful, especially when Vietnam is an agriculture country right now. So here's some pictures of our product. So in here, we don't use any plastic. We don't use any like toxic adhesive to increase the quality of it. Yeah, like plastic. Yeah, it's biodegradable, it's compostable, and the most and important thing is it's cost competitive comparing to the other eco alternative like bioplastic or like paper. Yeah, and let's just like imagine like today you have some like rice, like gumon. Yeah, and at the end, like if you threw it away, you are supposed to like separate the box and the food separately. It's really like complicated, but with this you can, you know, like put it together, just throw it away to put to the bin, and then it can be composted all together. Pretty like convenient, right? Yeah. So we believe that we have like three competitive that differentiate us from the others. Firstly, we are the first manufacturer in Vietnam, which means we have the first mover advantage. We can, you know, like talk to the stakeholder. We can like move on with suppliers to, you know, like gain advantage on the raw materials. Yeah, and by the time that when there's like another suppliers coming in, then it takes them like 3 to 6 months to catch up with us, and also the market share is gone by that time. Secondly, is we have really competitive price due to two reasons. For the first, we work directly with the raw material suppliers, which is Tran Quoc, like the biggest, one of the biggest sugarcane manufacturer in Vietnam right now. So we have like really good deal of the raw material, and because if we don't buy it, they will like throw it away anyway, or they can burn it. Secondly, is Vietnam right now, they have various trade agreement, which bring us, you know, like tax incentive. Also, we have lower tariff comparing to like China, comparing to Thailand, with like EU and US. And yeah, and personally, like I think like Vietnamese government is doing a great job right now getting those like trade agreement, so we have a really good advantage over the price compared to the other countries. So the last but not least is the guarantee customers. So as of now, we have like another business activities, which is producing paper straw, and it has, you know, like we are like have MOU of $850,000 in pre-order. So here's our traction. We do export. We do have like from like big coffee chain to, you know, like 5-star hotel, from local to, you know, like foreign. To foreign exporter. Yeah, and we like most of the customers are like coming back. Yeah. So the competitors are like classified into three types. The local manufacturers, actually like there's no manufacturers right now, so we are the one. And the local distributors, we have advantage over the quality improvement because we produce directly. And for the foreign manufacturers, we have the advantage over the pricing, and we can cater to the local market, like customization, labeling. Yeah. So for the target market, we in short term, we want to jump into the commodity, which is, you know, like highly acceptable like disposable packaging and food and foam tray. With the future, we want to go into your like some niche market like oligopoly, like airlines, food catering, and instant food packaging. It saves cost for like the airlines. It saves cost for the producer in here, and it makes like the people use it like guilt free. So the last slide, we are calling for like funding for two phases in 2020 and 2021. So for the phase one, we want to complete the 850,000 pre-orders. Yeah. And this is how the fund is allocated. And phase two is in 2021. And this one we plan to use the fund. Yeah. And that's the end of our presentation. Thank you.
So how much are you raising?
Okay, so sorry that intentionally left it up. So I intentionally raised $1 million to set up like the whole like the mass production plant to complete this order pre-orders. Yeah. And after that, like after 1 year of working, due to like our performance, we will like start continue for the second round. Yeah.
So for now, with that investment, how are you manufacturing?
So right now, like we do have the samples. We have like the sample lines only, which is really small, and because we push out the samples to the market and they like react really positive, so they want to order, like do the pre-order and so on. They already signed the contract already. That's why I'm here like calling for the investment. So in Vietnam dong, it costs about like 1,000 to 2,000 Vietnam dong, which is 1.5 to 2.5 times more expensive than like the traditional plastic. Yeah. Actually, I believe it's compostable and it's biodegradable as well, because everything, we don't use any additive during the production time. Yeah, and we like everything is made from your like agricultural waste. Like for example, this one is, and you can see here, it's all like bagasse and we press it. Yeah.
But then like how can you, for example, how if you get like a tabulated, how should we get those?
Actually we use the, actually we are working with Aneco, like the bioplastic supplier to have your like the cover in the carton box. So when we transport it, it's like over, and then we make sure that it's not contaminated during the export and during the transportation.
So is there any certification you need for using as a packaging?
Actually, yes. That's why I spent like 9% of the investment for certification in here. So let's say like each like different region, they require different certification. For example, for US is FDA, for Vietnam is like QCBN, and for Japan we have different one. Yeah, and besides that, we also have, you know, like compostable certification like TÜV Austria. Yeah, and furthermore, if we will go to more details, even the manufacturing plant, then we need to follow like some setup requirement, like let's say for HACCP or like even ISO 22000. Yeah. And all of that so we can be put in here. Yeah. And for the sample right now that we made, we already like sent it out for certification already. Yeah. So that's why like we make sure everything is done. And when we receive the money, we can just put everything down, roll out, and you know like go right away to market. Yeah.
Can you show me the team structure?
Yeah. Actually this slide is not updated. yeah. Yeah, so as of now we have like 3 people. Yeah, so me, my background is I work for like supply chain management field in like different company in different industry. Yeah, I used to study in UT State in supply chain and project management. And the second founder with me is he work in technical. Yeah, and the last one is in financial. Yeah. As of now, we do not have any revenue from this one because, as I say, we do not have any like mass production plan yet. But for the other for the current business activity, which is the paper shop, we have, you know, 100 million Vietnam dong, 200 million Vietnam dong per month, yeah, so far. And we just established in January of 2019. So we're building. And we plan to, you know, like, be not only sustainable in products, but also sustainable in financial. So I strongly believe that if we have the investment in here, we can like stand on our own feet as well. Yeah. Actually, I believe there are like two reasons. The first one is it's like the proven model. Second one, I think packaging is one of the most pollution cost for plastic. Yeah, people use plastic in everything. They wrap in the bakery, they wrap in the supermarket. They use it like in every occasional. So I believe that if we like start with that, we can, you know, like tackle like the big problem first. I guess, you know, like,
you change the idea of that kind of packaging?
No, actually, because the $850,000 is fixed already. We have like set up almost everything, and they even like put in the pre-order deposit money as well. Yeah. So I really want to, you know, seek for investment. Yeah. There's no like backing. Yeah.
This pre-order for how long?
This is the pre-order for 2020.
Just 1 year.
Yeah, just 1 year. But like the one who made the pre-order is already my customer in the paper shop. So that's why we have established a really, you know, like strategic relationship.